Hey, PV. As requested, I'll go ahead and I'll give the computer another test. Like you mentioned, I'll try to put some screen capture software on it for you. It doesn't have a built-in webcam, though. But I wanted to show you this and give it a little tweak. Time me and see how long this takes from pressing the button to start to getting into the operating system. 1, 2, 3, go. And time. Windows Update needs your help. Hasn't been able to check for updates. I have the Wi-Fi all set up on the original Vista that it came with, but I haven't yet set up the Wi-Fi for this one. Although, as you can see here, it can detect the networks. The Wi-Fi is just off. So what I'm going to do here is show you how to turn it on. That would be helpful, wouldn't it? There's a button here. There. You see this blue button here? This manually turns on or off the Wi-Fi. And I guess with Windows 10, okay, now it knows Wi-Fi is on. Okay. So I don't want you to think that the Wi-Fi is not working if that button happens to get depressed. In order to turn on the Wi-Fi, it's this button to the left of the power button. So that was probably a pretty quick startup, right? Clean install of the original Vista. When I got it, I didn't have any of that. I did the clean install. I registered it with the key that it has. So it's all totally legit, and I'll fix it up with a couple of extra things and get it off to you. Okay, I've installed screen capture software in Windows 10, but I should point out the Windows 10 that I installed on this is just the developer preview, so it's not taking up a big section of the hard drive. The original Vista that's on there has 50-something gigabytes of free space on the hard drive, so that's where you're going to want to put your stuff. But just in case you want it in Windows 10, I put screen capture in Windows 10 here, but I installed it to the partition of the hard drive that has the original operating system. So this is how this works. It'll open up, and there'll be a little, you can see at the top of your screen here, a little control bar, and you click on this video icon here. It'll give you this little message, and you just click next, and all the settings are right here. You want to capture your desktop. You probably want to do custom codecs. I'm going to configure it so that, 20 frames per second. This looks good. 192K audio. Okay, and so you click start when you want to start the capture, and to stop, you click the page break button, and that'll stop. It'll pull up the thing that it just recorded, and you can either review it and approve it or decline it, in which case it won't save, and you can decide where it saves. After you open the screen capture application, the little faint blue taskbar will still be at the top of the screen. Right there, and to close it, you just go to your bottom bar here, and you right-click and exit the application. So I'll check to make sure that the same application is installed on Vista, and that'll be that. Well, I should add, this doesn't have a built-in microphone. It has a jack for an external microphone. So if you have, your headset with the microphone attached, you would need that to record the audio part of your video screen capture stuff. Okay, here we are in Vista. It's pretty fast and snappy. Like I said, this is the main operating system on the drive, and the Windows 10 is just for preview purposes, so it's not allotted a large partition. Here you have space to work with. I put on your Snap software. It hasn't asked me for the registration code, but I put in the registration code in the actual file name. So if you go into Program Files and you look under this, it'll have the registration code as part of the name. Just a few other things, you know, Malwarebytes is always good to have. You'll need VLC Media Player. I like to use XNView to do screen caps. I put on a limited functionality version of CyberLink PowerDirector. I don't know what number this is, 10 or something like that. 11. And CPU Z, which is always good to have. Just a few things. Anyway. Yeah. I think that covers it. Oh, I haven't done any of the extensive updates that it's going to need, so that's up to you. It's running really fast right now, so whatever you decide to do to it, you know, it's yours from here.